Who thought life would be like this when you're younger?
Oh no man, things ain't the same.
Ain't the same.
We went through that pain and that hunger.
Oh no man,
I don't know man.
I'm just trying to make it out.
Can't tell me nothing, I've been around on that road.
That road.
I'm just trying to get rich then go.
Get rich then go.
Can't tell me nothing, I've been around on that road.
That road.
I'm just trying to get rich then go.
These kids don't know religion. Put their faith into the streets.
Streets.
Set their hope on wishing that their pain will be relieved.
Yeah, I'm from Manor Park. Like, I've been from Manor Park from since I was like 6 years old. Like, when I first moved to a country. Actually, I was living in Beckton for like 1 week. And then I moved to Manor Park. I've been there ever since, so this is like my home. So I just from Manor Park. Basically, when I was like, I think I was 11, I used to rap in it. Like, I used to just rap because I had friends who in the area who had a studio and that. So they just used to be like, yeah, man, start rapping, yeah, just rap. I didn't really want to rap, but you know, they made me do it. And when they made me do it, what started to happen was a lot of people started to know my face. Like, not saying I was famous or anything, I wasn't famous. Like, I wasn't known beyond my area, but a lot of people knew my face, a lot of people knew my name. And everywhere I'd go, it just caused problems for me. So like, they're like, I'd be with my boys, I'd be with a group of my friends, and they'll just be like, him. You know what I mean? Like, they always used to just look it, used to just know that it's me all the time. So ever since that happened, I was just like, nah, I need to switch my image up. So then, you know, I was inspired, you know, I saw a couple people, I was inspired, and I just thought, let me go Jeds. So that's how I started going Jeds, and it's different as well, and I like it, and it's like, it's become a part of me, so I just had Jeds. I've had Jeds for like 2.5 years now, so I just live with them now.
Be best.
Any opportunity I see, I'm gonna take it. So I'm not gonna say I didn't see it coming. You know, I saw the little popularity coming, but that still don't mean anything to me. You know what I mean? I still don't think I've achieved as much as I can achieve. You know what I mean? There's still a lot more for me to do. That still don't mean nothing. You know what I mean? But the thing I am proud of mostly is all the connections I've made and all the networking I've done with people and all the friends I now have, all the people in the creative world that I now know. That's what I'm most proud of. Not the YouTube views or people saying, yo, that's you on the street, or people, nah, I don't like that. That's not the side of it that I like. I like the connecting people, getting to know different kind of people, understanding their culture, and them also understanding your culture and your background and where you come from. That's what I think is more important than anything.
Yeah, well, them sound good, man. The record, yeah, we got that little vibe there, yeah?
Yeah, I'm feeling the vibe. You man have talent, man. Yeah.
Thanks,
man. You get, man, keep up the work, man. Yeah. You man have talent. Definitely some talent there. And when I'm listening to your beats, your kick patterns, them nice. Drums, them nice. Yeah. But you see, your synths, try to get them a bit mixed more.
Oh, yeah,
your
synths
are always a bit far away.
Yeah.
Work on your synths, try to get them...
Try and bring them closer, yeah?
Try to get them that mix with the sound more fully.
Yeah.
But otherwise on that, you're getting everything right. Your bass tight, your kick, your snare them tight. But listen to your stuff, most of your synths them,
yeah.
Just try to get them to mix.
Yeah.
When you start learning after a while, you need to learn how to get your mix them
definitely,
more up.
Definitely.
You see, the music thing is something that, like, it's basically I've been forced into the music thing, like. The truth is, when I was like 8 or 9, I always knew what I wanted to be in it. I knew what I wanted to be. I knew I wanted to be an actor. From when I was like 9, I always knew that. Like, it was never something where I just you know, I just saw something and thought, it made me think, ah, that's what you want to do now. I knew that's what I wanted to be. So I never ever wanted to be a lawyer, doctor, all of this stuff. I never really wanted to be that. So I knew I wanted to be an actor. And I believe that acting, dancing and music is all part of the same kind of creative kind of thing. So it's all the same thing. So like, around my era, there's a lot of producers, DJs, musicians and all of that. So then I just used to hang around them. Because, like, you know, I wasn't really into the street thing like that. Nah, I wasn't really into that. Like, nah, that just wasn't my thing. Like, I was just smart and it worked. I have a lot of street friends, people who are from the streets or whatever. But I just watched them, you know. I used to do my little things with them. And then when it used to get to the point where there's trouble or anything, like, not trouble is there's a friend that I wouldn't back my friends, but I meant like, as in, when the whole getting involved with police and stuff like that, I just knew that that's not the way. And plus I had an older brother as well, and my older brother was just getting involved with police and whatnot, so that just used to deter me. That I'd just be like, nah, that's not what I'm doing. So I just used to stick with it. Let's do something, let's make something, let's create something, you know what I mean? So then one summer I just got a new laptop and that, because my house got burgled and that, and I lost my other laptop in it. So then I got a new laptop and I just started playing around Fruity Loops, playing around, the rest is history. You know what I mean? And I'm still working, still trying to get better, still trying to improve every time, because I haven't been doing it for that long. There's people who've been doing music for how many years, you know what I mean? They're still improving, so I'm just trying to work hard and just carry on improving and doing everything.
Me and my kid, she's loyal. Loyal. My little girl, yeah, she's loyal.
You see who you are?
She ain't no girl, but she's loyal.
Yeah, man. My baby girl, yeah, she's loyal.
Yeah.
She ain't gonna cry, but she's loyal.
Anyway, I think 2014, yeah. I started making beats in 2014, summer. Yeah, summer. I had nothing to do, so. But I did have things to do, but, you know, I was playing around with FL Studio and that, and then I just died. You know what I mean? I used to make beats on my TV. I used to connect the HDMI cable to my TV because I never had speakers.
Wait, instead of love, because that's a bit cheesy.
Yeah, that's cheesy.
Wait, wait, we can say, but you know I'm with you.
Yeah, cool. You can say that, it's like, cool. I know I never say it, but you know I'm with you.
Yeah, I look around about you. These girls are the only one wants. The fame that comes at the price. Soon as I find
out, I was fucking with this. Yeah. Oh, you can tell that I was doing something else and I was thinking about you, no?
I was chilling
on the block, yeah.
I was chilling on the block, chilling with my niggas.
Yeah.
I was chilling.
Yeah. So he can say one bit and he can say the other bit.
Yeah.
Thinking about you, I know I never say I was thinking about
you. Hey, brother, the timing is over, fam. The time is finished.
Time's over.
Who went first last time? He's going first.
T. Yeah, but you see,
get out of here.
I want it to sound exactly like that when I'm going in as well, though, because
it's gonna sound exactly like that. No changes. That's how I make my beats, brother. Put the same way.
Jeez, Dr. Dre.
Yeah, Dr. Beats, Dr. Dre. You know what I mean? No one's got my style. I made my own style. You know what I mean? That's why my beats don't sound like no nigga style. You hear me?
Yeah.
I would knock me out like a right hook. These girls, they only want one thing. See the fame, yeah, it comes at a price. Soon as I find me a dumping, the other hoes get pushed to the side. She was on me before I was Kino. She was on me before all of these hoes.
She know my name, get about like a slogan. Jiggle jiggle to the left, jiggle jiggle to the right. Then I give her the fast and slow motion. Tech time bend her back like this. Tech time bend her back like that. There's no girl too stush for the wood.
When she with the team, she don't act like that. And we ain't never been too flashy. It still comes to my guys, ask Laddie. Spend all your savings on clothes and still tech your gal in the
pack. My real name's Blair, so that just comes with it. So, just made it blurry, innit, that?
Blurry.
It just sounds nice, blurry. And then the Hendrix obviously came from, you know, the musical inspiration, like I said earlier, from Future. I've been listening to Future for ages. So, that's where the Hendrix come from. So, it's just stuck now, innit, Blurry Hendrix. And also, obviously, Jimi Hendrix as well, the first black rock star. So, that's where all that inspiration comes from. That's where my name comes from. That's just the name for that anyway, but my real name is also there. For other things that I'm doing, so Larry Hendrix is just for when I'm producing or when I'm some sort of personality or something. Larry Hendrix can use that. And then when I'm doing my proper things where government names have to be put on there, it's there as well. So both of the names, both of them. Now, basically what we went through was, we just went through planning stages and that for the thing, innit? And like, and as we started actually doing it, we started to realize that, okay, we need this, we need this. So it was like a learning curve, innit? So we started off by writing just scripts, and then we started to try film scripts, innit?
But you said you need a script writer.
Yeah, because we're gonna revamp it. You know what I mean? So we started off writing scripts, and then we just started doing scripts, and then when we tried to actually have a shoot there and do the script, we started realizing that, nah, like, there's not enough work being done. We can't just write a script and go film. It don't make sense. You get? We realize that there needs to be more work behind the thing. You know what I mean? You can't just write a script, and just go outside and expect that, you know what I mean, for it to be on point, you know what I mean? So what we did was we went back to the drawing board, didn't it?
Yeah.
And then we actually started to, you know, design characters in detail and everything.
Yeah.
So now, if you look at this, you're going to have to look at it in detail, innit? But just for you to just see what kind of thing we're going for, you have to kind of just look at these little bullet points, innit? We're both Ghanaian, we're both African. We know how this game works, yeah?
We know
how this game works. When you're flipping six racks off there each episode because it's getting 1 million views on your channel.
You don't get 1 million views.
You see, this has
you will not get 1 million views.
Who knew that RS will get 1 million views?
No disrespect, It's good to be ambitious, It's good to be ambitious.
Yeah.
But this, what we're going for, is not a comedy, is it?
No,
we're not going for a comedy.
We're not going.
But it's going to be very grabbing, and with the faces that we're going to have in it.
I want it to be grabbing. But at the same time,
what we're going for is something new.
Yeah, it's cool.
And we're going to take our time.
Especially on your platform.
And no disrespect to you, but people go for things that I knew before.
It's true. No, so you're
this,
right.
This is what I'm saying. This could come on here, and I'm telling you, no disrespect to you whatsoever. This could even be the best production in the world.
Yeah.
But just because people in the UK aren't even being given something that's funny or something that's lives up to the stereotype, as it were, they might not gravitate towards it. And for me, the view count in this instance isn't even the main thing. For me, it's the quality of work.
Yeah.
Hey, birthday boy, the future, you know. This guy here, he's the future. The future of the industry. Remember I said that. You just need to stop trying to jingles me.
You need to stop trying to make money out of me. I'm numbers. I'm in full-time education. Right now. You know, it's hard to balance, you know, full-time education with this creative stuff you're doing. You know what I mean? And every now and then, you know what I mean? Sometimes you gotta go back to the streets and just visit the guys who are still on the roads and whatever. You know what I mean? Just go visit them sometimes just to show them what life is like on your side, you know what I mean? And they can also show you what life is like on their side. And there's a lot of similarities, you know what I mean? People who are on the streets to make out as if they're some bad people or something. They're not bad people, it's just, you know, circumstance, you know what I mean? Like, not everyone has their mum or whatever guiding them, telling them that this is the way they should live their life or constantly putting pressures on them. Some people's mum don't care about them, so that's why they end up there. Not because they choose to end up there, so sometimes you also got to visit them, also understand their side of life. And I'm telling you, there's a lot of inspiration I get from people who are still on the streets. So, you know what I mean? There's a lot of inspiration there. So I'm just around, but I'm in full-time education still. So I look to finish that off as well.
Beat bass is my score.
Give me a minute, let me go build it.
I met Blairy on social media, Social media. Mo Stack, Stop Lying, Rich Not Famous. They're like two of my favourite from Mo Stack and Blairy himself, so yeah. Not yet, but when we do, it's gonna be great quality stuff. Me and Blairy have like we there's projects in works, but I'm not gonna talk too much. You know, I don't wanna give away too much, but we got some stuff on the way. Yeah. No one, like, especially his age. There's no one I can, at his age, there's no one I can sit down with or have sat down with and have a full grown ass conversation with. The maturity and the aura I get from Blairy is like, for his age, is something rare, man. You know, we need more young people like Blairy. I'm young as well, by the way. So I've progressed very far. He's got a teachings of the industry, musically and acting wise, that a lot of people don't have, and a focus which a lot of people don't have, you know. So yeah, I think at a young age like that, to have a focus like he does, it can't be taught. You just need to have it. Like, compared to where he is now, he's got a mindset, man. It's a focus thing. Like, the focus he's got, you can't teach. Big up Blairy, man. You done no money.
Inspiring, man. It's just crazy. Like, it just shows that, you know, a boy from South London that's like 23, 22 can do something, you know what I mean? A black boy from South London. It's sad for me to be even saying black, but that's just the reality of it, innit? Like, you know, black people have this stigma that we can't do anything and we're road youth or whatever. But, you know, just to see something like that, it's motivational. It's crazy motivation. I even went to see that. Like, that was like my first cinema trip in like 6 months. Because I had to see that. I was like, no matter what, I'd never watched Star Wars. I've never seen any Star Wars before that one. I just knew that one, I had to go and see it because it's just support, you know what I mean? From London, black boy from London that's that young, doing his thing, and I'm just happy for him and whatever goes on in his career. You know what I mean? I just hope he keeps elevating, going up, and that will hopefully elevate us who are also coming up. So all of that is positive. So, There's one short film I did with Remy, Aaron Moses. He's also doing his thing. Yeah, which was it was premiered in Genesis Cinema last October, yeah, in 2015. That's still yet to come out, you know. It's doing quite well in a couple film festivals right now, so that's still to come out in this year, 2016. And I'm also doing another short with him this year as well. So I really like working with him because, you know what I mean, he believes in me, you know what I mean? Like, I didn't have to show him anything for him to believe me. He just knows how serious I am in everything that I do, despite my age, you know what I mean? When he asked me my age, he was surprised. He was thinking, wow, like, you're 17 or whatever, and you want to do this and you want to do that. So I'm definitely doing stuff with him. And then I've got my own, you know, on my YouTube channel and that. I'm going to be having my own solo project coming out, but I don't want to name the ideas and that, but trust me, it's going to be worth it when it comes out. But it's just a wait, you know, film takes time. You know what I mean? I can make 10 beats in one day, but I can't make 10 films. You get me? It can take me 2 to 3 months to come up with scripts and everything to do a short film. Whereas to make a beat, I could just phone up 2 mates or man to just be around me to give me that inspiration, and we can make beats all day. So when people are asking me, you call yourself an actor, but more beats and more songs are coming out more than film or theatre, is that theatre I have to rehearse like for 25 weeks for. And making a beat, I can sit down and think, go on the laptop and make the beat, you know what I mean? That's different, so, you get me? So that's the difference between it. So whenever you see that, when I'm calling myself that, you understand the differences, so, you know what I mean? That's why it's like that. But yeah, I'm gonna be doing a lot more auditions this year and next year, and hopefully something will come through for me, hopefully. I'm looking for my dad. Excuse me, boss, can I have your wife?
Baby, watch your love. Baby, watch your love.
You cooked your love.
You cooked your love.
Okay, it's good.
Block D. All the chicks in this block get the D. Look. Block. Hey, see, if you go to Leicester University, this is the block to be, man. Bad D's going about that. Look.